Good morning students. Today let us learn about verbs, active and passive voice. A transitive verb has two voices, active voice and passive voice. Transitive verb means a verb which has an object. Okay? When the subject of a verb also performs the action named in the verb is said to be in the active voice. Let us take one example. Sudha respects the teacher. Okay, here what is the subject? What is the subject of the verb? Respects Sudha. Okay, Sudha performs the action respect. Okay, so we can say Sudha is the subject here. Okay? And what is the action performed? Respecting. Okay? That is the verb. Respect. Okay? And the subject of the verb performs the action named in the verb. Okay? What action? Respecting. Okay, and this sentence is said to be in the active voice. Okay, when the subject of a verb performs the action named in the verb is said to be in the active voice. Okay, then when the subject of a verb receives the action named in the verb is said to be in the passive voice. Okay? Then we can write the same sentence in passive voice like the teacher is respected by Sudha. Okay? Here, what is the action performed? Respecting. Okay? What is the subject of the verb? Is respected? The teacher. Okay? Does the teacher perform the action of respecting? No. Okay? The subject receives the action of respecting. Okay? Sudha performs the action in active voice, but in passive voice, the teacher is the subject and she receives the action. Okay? Then, the subject of a verb receives the action named in the verb is said to be in the passive voice. Okay? We always use passive voice if the person or the thing that performs the action is unknown or is an unimportant. Okay, that time we use the passive voice. Let us learn about the passive voice in detail. Simple present tense. Active voice form is subject plus first form of the verb plus object. Okay? The passive voice form of simple present tense is subjective form of object is or am or are plus third form of the verb plus by plus objective form of subject. In active voice, first subject comes. But in passive voice, first the active voice object comes. Okay? What is given in the active voice? The object. That object will come in first. Okay? Let us take one example. He obeys his parents. Here, he is subject, obey or obeys. Obeys is the root form of the verb obey. Okay, we know S is here because he is singular. Okay, and his parents is the object. Okay, then it is in active voice, and we have to convert this one into passive voice. Then we have to check the form first. This sentence is in simple present tense. Okay, then we have to change this word into simple present passive voice form. Okay, first we have to write the subjective form of object. This one, his parents is the object, and we have to take his parents at first. Then his parents, it is plural. Okay, so we can use are here. Okay, then subjective form of object plus is, am or are plus third form of the verb obey. What is the third form of obey? Obeyed plus by. After that, by is coming. Then objective form of subject. Okay, here the subject is he. We have to take the subject in the object place. Then he will become him. Okay, then his parents are obeyed by him. It is the passive voice of he obeys his parents. Okay, here he performs the action obey, and here his parents in the passive voice, his parents receive the action obey. Okay, so we can say his parents are obeyed by him. It is the passive voice of he obeys his parents. Okay, in the active voice, if the subject is he, she, it, they, I, we have to convert it into its objective form in the passive voice, because the subject will become the object in the passive voice. So we have to convert it. Okay, he will become him. Okay, and she will change into her. Okay, they will change into them. I will change into me. We will change into us. Okay, you have no changes. You can write you as it is. Okay, it also we can write it. No change. And any noun is coming, Manu, then no change. Same noun we can write. Only pronoun we have to change. Okay, then in active voice, the object is, if it is him, then it will change in subject place. In passive voice, he, then her, she, and them, they, me, I, us, we, you, and it, no change. And the noun also, no change is there. Then, if we take the active voice in question, then how will we change this one into passive voice? Example, does he, same we have to convert into yes or no question. Does he obey his parents? Question mark. Then you know that this is simple present tense active voice. Simple present tense active voice. So does is coming. Okay. And we know that in simple present tense we use is or are or am as auxiliary verb in passive voice. Okay, so here object is his parents. We have to take it first. Then his parents, we have to take it first, but this is question, so auxiliary verb we have to take first. Here the auxiliary verb is coming is, am or are. His parents is plural. So we have to use are here. So first we have to take are. Why? Because this one is question. So the passive voice also we have to make question. Okay, in passive voice. So first are is coming, are, then his parents obeyed by objective form of subject. He is the subject here and we have to take one into him. Are his parents obeyed by him? This is the passive voice of this question. Okay. Nothing is here. Only you have to take the auxiliary verb in front of the subject. If any question word is coming, then you can simply add question verb in the first, means before the auxiliary verb. Okay. Example. How does she do all this? This is a question. Question word question. Okay. You know that this one is in simple present tense. Okay. Does is also coming there. And we have to change this one into passive voice. First we have to write in the passive voice the question word. Here the question word is how. Then we write here how. Okay, then does means she is singular, so does we have used in active voice. Okay, but in passive voice we have to take the object, all this. Okay, then all this, this is singular. Okay, so we can use is here. Okay, all this, this is singular. So is we have written here. How is, then the object, all this. Okay, subjective form of object, but no change here. Then the verb third form, do is the verb here. First third form of do is done. Done, then by is coming, by. Then the subject, she, it's we have to use the objective form of she. Objective form of she is her. Okay, then question mark. How is all this done by her? Okay, now it is in passive voice. Next one more example we can take by question word. Okay. Who keeps the accounts? Okay. This is the active voice. Here, this one you know that keeps is coming. So it is simple present tense. Okay. And who is coming? Whenever who is coming as question word, we can use by whom. Okay, by whom. Then the object, the accounts. Okay, the accounts is singular or plural? Plural. Okay, account is the singular. So we use here are. Okay, by whom are, then the object, means a subjective form of object we have to write here. The accounts, then keep. Okay, keep means first form of the verb, keep. Okay, and we have to use the third form, past participle form. Then past participle form is kept. Okay, then question mark. By whom are the accounts kept? Okay, this is one method. Or another one more method is there. Who, by in place of by whom, we can write who. Okay, then auxiliary verb. The accounts is plural, so we have to use here are. who are, then the accounts, subjective form of object. Who are the accounts, then third form of the verb. Third form of the verb is kept. Okay, then we have to take by. Okay, who are the accounts kept by? Okay, this is the passive voice of who keeps the accounts. Okay, students, hope you have understood simple present tense, active voice and passive voice. In our next class, we will learn about the passive voice of simple past tense and simple future tense. Okay, let us end this section here. Thank you.